let's talk about the diels-alder reaction. And we know that in a diels-alder reaction, you have a diene and a dienophile, and that diels-alder reactions work best when the diene has electron-donating groups on it, and the dienophile has electron-withdrawing groups on it. We know that we get a six-member ring-type product, and we know that the electrons move in the manner shown by these arrows in a concerted fashion to give us the product. What I want to focus on is, in this product, the relative orientation of my substituents. In other words, this electron donating group and this electron withdrawing group. Are they cis to one another in my product, or are they trans to one another? And in order to do that, in order to look at that, we need to look at how this diene and this dienophile approach one another. And even though we normally draw our reaction like this, this doesn't really represent how the groups approach one another. They approach one another in what's called the endo approach, where the electron withdrawing groups are underneath the diene. And this is a really tricky thing to draw in a two-dimensional model. I've tried to draw it here, but it's really hard to visualize. It's much easier to see in this three-dimensional model that I can rotate. You can see this is my diene with two double bonds. These brown spheres represent my electron donating groups. Dienophile down the bottom, the purple spheres are my electron withdrawing groups. And what you can see if I rotate this is that the electron withdrawing groups are extended underneath the double bonds of my diene. This is the endo approach. We can understand why the endo approach is preferred if we look at the orbitals on these molecules. If we do that, what you see is, focusing just on the blue orbitals that are on my diene, you can see that the purple electron withdrawing groups are hanging out right underneath these orbitals. And because there are electrons in these orbitals, they actually help stabilize the electron withdrawing groups, which are a little bit electron deficient. In fact, if these electron withdrawing groups are something like cyano, which have p orbitals on them themselves, you can see that the p orbitals on my electron withdrawing groups actually interact with the p orbitals on the diene. And this wouldn't be the case if we didn't have the endo approach, if we had these groups sticking out where these white hydrogens are. So that's why we get the endo approach. Let's look at how this helps us predict the product we get. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw in the new bonds that form. So a new bond forms between this carbon and this carbon, and between this carbon and this carbon. And then we know we get some movement of the double bonds. So I'm not going to rearrange anything. I'm just going to draw in the new bonds. And that's what this structure is. I've drawn in my new bonds. I've moved the double bond to get this. And you might recognize that this is the boat form of our six-member ring, not the most stable form. And we'll rearrange this in a minute. But what I want you to notice is that if I rotate this, my electron withdrawing group and my electron donating group from over here, electron donating, electron withdrawing, are pointing in the same direction. And that's going to be really important for us when we decide what our product looks like. So this is actually the energy minimized form of that boat structure. It just cleaned up the angles a little bit. You can see that the two substituents, the electron withdrawing and donating, are still pointing in the same direction. I want to draw this structure over here after I rearrange it and rotate it a little. So this is my boat form of the product after I've spun it a little bit. And this is my two-dimensional drawing of it over here. And what you should notice in both of these representations is that my electron donating group and my electron withdrawing group, they're both pointed in the same direction. Down, 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 down. Which means when I draw a more normal representation of this, whether it be in a chair form or a regular planar representation, in this particular reaction, all of my substituents are cis to one another. And as I said, I can draw it in this chair form or in this more planar form showing the groups being cis.